This, as many of you may know, is a Tesla. And if you've ever tried to work on a Tesla, you also know getting a hold of Tesla's diagnostic software to figure out what's going on with the car is almost impossible until now. I'm gonna show you how to get to the website as well as how to connect your car and what you can see inside the software. The first thing you're gonna need is this Ethernet cable right here, which has an Ethernet port on one end and this 4-pin connector on the other. Depending on the year of your car, the plug that you need to connect to is either located behind the cubby that usually lies right here. Mine is kind of behind here because I have these jet controls in the way, but you pull that cubby down and out, or it's located behind this side panel here. That's where mine is located. And this is a Model S. I'm not sure about the other models. And this is the plug that you need to connect to right here, this 4-pin connector. So first thing we're gonna do is go to your browser and type in service.tesla.com, just like that. And then you're gonna go to this page here and scroll down to service subscriptions, learn more, and then we're gonna go down, choose your region, North America, China, or Europe, then hit diagnostic software. Here's the pricing details and what it includes. And then also on this page, you have the service and repair information. So let's go to diagnostic software and then click sign up now. If you don't already have a service account, you need to sign up. This is not connected to your personal Tesla account. Let's go to create account. After you sign in or create your account, you go up here to purchase. Then you select account type, individual, continue to subscription. And then here is where you're gonna select your options. Choose your duration, enter your billing details, make your payment. Once that payment processes, your subscription should be active. And now we're gonna scroll down, hit access toolbox software. So now taking a look at our dashboard here, that's my account. Let's hit connect to vehicle. Make sure you have your Ethernet cable connected as well as your USB to Ethernet adapter. And now we're gonna go over here, vehicle connection, and then we're gonna hit connect. And there we go, we're connected. That's my VIN. Here's our dashboards. And these dashboards are basically a list of actions that are needed for that particular repair. So like this is rear drive unit replacement. And this is all of the actions that you have to perform if you do a rear drive unit replacement. Now, really important, I just want to let you know that right now, as far as I know, this is really new. Not many people know about this. Some people in Tesla don't even know about this. Not everything works at this time. However, and there's also a lot of stuff in this program that's meant for like a Model X or a Model 3, not for the Model S. And it's not really stated what applies to what, so you might as well just take a guess for now. However, even the way it sits right now, I still think that this software is worth the money, because if I had access to this software a few months ago when I fixed my drive unit, this thing would have saved me 3 weeks easy just going right here to this tab. It's called Vitals. If we read Vitals, we have a lot of data here. And one of the things that's very important for troubleshooting, like an isolation error, for instance, in my case, if you look at this BMS ISO, you see where it says 1700. So that's basically 1700,000 ohms that the BMS is reading. So that's 1.7 million ohms. That's basically the resistance reading on the high voltage bus. If we refresh the Vitals, BMS ISO, 1.64 million ohms. So this is a snapshot of what was happening a few moments ago, but it's still very helpful if you're troubleshooting an isolation error. Like I said, in my case, this would have helped me immensely. So that's telling you it's 1.7 million ohms, which I think looks kind of low, but that's what it is. Also gives you a lot more information about the car. If you go to DTCs, which is diagnostic trouble codes, it's gonna show you right here in this area. And then also another bit of information that would really help you in troubleshooting, if we scroll down here, it's going to give us recent alerts. These are all hidden alerts. These are things that are going on with the car that just doesn't show you on the display. Some of the more severe alerts, it shows you on the display. And these are just things that happened while I was driving. Now, apart from the Vitals and the trouble codes, there's a few other things here in this software that I find very valuable. This right here is another very important one, clear BMS isolation alert counters. These cars have an isolation counter. So if you hit, I believe, 10 isolation faults in one ignition cycle, then the car locks and the contactor will not close and the car will not start. If I had access to this, again, this would have made my life much easier when I had my high voltage isolation problem, because when I was moving my car from one garage to the other in order to complete the repair, my car locked up twice. One time it was stuck right outside of the garage door and the car would not start. I could not move the car, and all I needed to do was clear the BMS isolation counter to get it another 25 feet into the garage on the lift and start fixing it. Well, looks like I found my isolation fault, but I didn't have access to this. Another one is coolant air purge start. What this does when you run this procedure is fire up all the pumps, open the diverter valves, and allow all that air to get bled out of the cooling system so you can add more coolant and you don't end up with air in the system. Because if you have air in the system on these cars, they will shut down right there and then until you get that air out and get more coolant in the system. This is a big one here, so you properly purge the coolant in the event that you either change a hose or a charger or any other components. Pretty much everything on this car is water cooled, so that's very important. And the way you run these procedures is you just hit that and you hit run, and then it sends the command. And as you can see, I have an error on mine. I'm not sure why. I'm still trying to figure that out. I contacted Tesla. They're working on it. But like I said, this software is very new. Don't be too hard on them. At least they're going in the right direction and they're allowing the general public access to this diagnostic software. I'm sure it's gonna get better with time. I mean, it has to, right? But this is what it is. And I think this is pretty amazing that Tesla's doing this. It's a step in the right direction for sure. And you can also do simple stuff like check the wiper heaters, for instance. You can check the circuit, run, pass. That just about wraps this video up. Now you know what Tesla Toolbox 3 is. I hope it helps you. I hope this was some useful information so you don't end up in the situation that I was in.
It left me stranded, it won't restart.
Where I had absolutely no diagnostic tools at all, because as everybody knows, something is better than nothing. And although I don't do that many how-to videos anymore, I really thought this was important, and this is something that everybody who has a Tesla or who doesn't have a Tesla should know about. And keep in mind, at the time this video was filmed, which is November 5th, 2021, I can't find any sort of support link for this software from Tesla. Even in my case, I purchased this subscription so I can run a coolant purge and do a few other things. I was not able to run those procedures, and I wasn't able to get a refund either. So I just gave up. I decided to do this video instead, but the vitals do work and there is some valuable information in the software. So thanks for watching. Tell me what you think in the comments below. In a future video, I'm going to show you a program that a friend of mine wrote that allows you to pull live data from the Tesla real time, anytime, and gives you all sorts of valuable information from the onboard components. I'm very excited to share that with everybody, so make sure you subscribe. Look out for that video. It's coming real soon. And check out my other channel called Warped Perception. See you next time. Thanks again for watching.